So one of the most powerful features in Keynote is Magic Move. Magic Move is a transition from one slide to the next where the objects are animated so they actually move. It's much better than a standard thing like a dissolve or a wipe or something like that. Let me show you an example. Say we want to show on this slide that we have three objects and this large object container here. And in the next slide we want to show that they go into the container. So I'm going to select the slide here. I'm going to duplicate the slide. So Command D will do that. On the duplicate I'm going to move these objects into here. So I'm going to put it in there. Put this one here. Put this one here. Now I can have a simple transition go from one side to the next. So I'll select the first slide. I'll click Animate and I'll add an effect, say Dissolve. And this creates something that's not very exciting. So I'm on this first slide, I go to the next slide and it dissolves over to it. And I can do all sorts of things, some wipes and things like that. But a much better effect would be to actually have things animate so they move into there. So I'm going to change from Dissolve and I'm going to choose Magic Move, which is kind of in a category by itself. And it shows you exactly what that's going to look like. So if I run it now and I go from one side to the next, you can see them move there. Now you can do this in multiple steps too. So for instance, if I really want to show these items being dropped in there, I can create another duplicate here. So I'm going to duplicate this slide here. And in the middle slide, instead of them being in here, I am going to move them up. So they should move from there to there and then drop in. I need to go and create a magic move for this one as well. It's done on the first slide, so you don't have to do it on the second slide. So this one will move it right up there, and then when I go to the next slide, they drop down. Now I can have this happen in one fluid motion if I change this magic move here, the one in the middle. You can see on the right I have start transition on click. I'll just say do it automatically and with no delay. So now it won't wait on this slide. So I go to the first slide here. I will advance, take my hands off the keyboard, and it will drop in automatically. So that's what I want to happen. You can also play with the acceleration. So right now it's easing in and out. And when I have a two-part here, I might want to ease in on the first one and ease out on the second one. That creates a more fluid one. Or I could simply say no acceleration on either one and it would move in and do the animation in a linear manner. So you can use this for all sorts of things. Some things to pay attention to is the objects should be the same objects. So it's important to duplicate the slide so that these three objects here, when I duplicate them, they're the same three objects here and the same three objects there. If I were to recreate them, create a new slide and put three new shapes on it, even if they looked exactly the same, they would be different shapes and you wouldn't get this animation. So always duplicate the slide before using Magic Move. A cool thing that Magic Move does is if an item is different, if it's new or if it's been removed, it actually just uses a fade. So if I were to put another object here like a piece of text, and maybe have that not on the second one, and on the third one have a new piece of text. Instead of being confused by this item that is there on the first one, not on the second one, and a new item on the third one, it will just fade it. So you can see the word start there. You can see it fades out very nicely and then the new text fades in. So it works gracefully with objects that are new or have been removed from slides as well. And of course, even if you don't give presentations, this kind of animation could be very valuable if you make videos. Because of course you can export as a movie and create a video. So if you're creating a video with some clips of yourself and things in it and you want to do an animation in the middle using shapes and text and all. You can do that in Keynote, export it as a video, and then import that into iMovie to use in the middle of your movie project.